In PDI DreamWorks computer animated comedy, Dirty, Stinky, Green, and Very Happy Ogre has his world turned upside down when an army of fairy tale creatures invades his swamp.
Stuff that we see all the time and obviously take for granted, but in CG is a whole nother story. And to make it believable, and not photoreal, because again, it's not what the story called for, but to make it believable as part of the world that we're creating.
Conceptualizing the fantastic visual style of the Mayan-inspired world of El Dorado began when the film's creative team traveled to the lush jungles and towering ancient temples of Central America.
We took a fantastic whirlwind trip to Mexico, saw a number of sites. It was an incredibly valuable trip. You know, the artists had some time to sketch, which of course helped our production design team come make some decisions about, you know, what the city of El Dorado would look like.
The blue, the red, yellow, like that's original color.
It is a beautiful, beautiful culture that was extremely colorful. And we recreated what must have existed then.
What we wanted to do in this movie, though, was to sort of take inspiration from that and just blow it out bigger than life, because truly, this is meant to be Shangri-La.
It is like nothing you've ever seen, I believe, in animation before.
The special effects in the movie, which are huge, you know, we crash these gates, we blow up this, we got this jaguar that comes to life, and you know, we've put every kind of bell and whistle that, you know, is in our arsenal these days just to make this as fun and entertaining and a big adventure.
But as story developed and characters developed, it made more sense to us that the film take on a more homogeneous look. And the style of our characters began to influence the style of our jungle, which wasn't a huge leap because we're still working in a very graphic way.
I mean, there have been 100% animated, computer graphic generated films, but they haven't taken human-like characters and sustained a story for a whole feature length.
3D character animation in El Dorado, I think, is something to really be proud of for the movie, because they've created 3D character animation with a lot more facial animation than we're used to seeing. And the acting of the 3D characters is what I'm really most proud of.
From the outset, we said we wanted this to be a funny, physical film, you know, from an animation point of view.
The dialogue is still along the same lines. We're still like, come on, guys, let's go, you know, instead of, come on, guys, let's go, come on, guys, let's go.
It's amazing. I'd love to see the Rugrats age 10 years.
That Emeka Cece is brand new. Hand it over.
Leave them little kids alone.
They probably get into more mischief than they did as babies.
For me, as an artist, I love drawing animals. I love drawing action, adventure, and the Thornberrys has it all. It's one of the few cartoons I know of that just has everything.
I'm so looking forward to seeing this on a big screen because I love the way it's drawn. The actual artwork is extraordinary, and to see it on a big screen, I cannot wait.
Really expressive, you know, crazy faces that are really malleable, that aren't locked to a skull and, you know, just muscles moving over skull. We're actually changing the shape of the skulls, and we kind of threw away a lot of the anatomy, the muscles and things, so that we could stretch and elongate our characters' arms and squash their torsos down when they need to get physical.
The ants go marching one by one, hurrah, hurrah.
I am proud to send you into battle.
We slaughter termites just for fun, hurrah.
Forward!
Come on, let's kick some termite butt.
I think the important thing to say here, instead of getting very technical, is a scene that used to take 9 months to try to put together, now you can do them in about 3 days.
We initially went out and shot red screen mats where the characters were going to be in the grass, so we could pull mats for the grass, lay the characters in, then lay the grass back on top.
And in order to kind of pull the audience into that, we took a cinematography style, which is very kind of live action. We used all digital sets so that we could get in there and move through them in a three-dimensional way, and try to put the camera right down on the water, like the whole thing was being shot by a raft that's floating down the river with them. So it's all has a kind of a handheld feel to it. It's all very dramatic.
The part in the Red Sea, it had to be huge. It had to have an incredible scale. It had to be scary. It had to be magical. It had to be awe-inspiring. So what we've done is we've created an animated painting, effectively, in Prince of Egypt.
Wow, you can do this stuff in 3D. I can move the camera over here if I really want. If that's a better composition, I can do that. Now, he's thought these story panels through, and he knows exactly what he wants. But there is something thrilling about once you see it in 3D and you got what you want. But you know, if I move the camera over here, I got something better.
The artists used all the effects tools at their disposal to create some of the most eye-popping visual effects sequences ever achieved in animation.
Traditionally, to hand draw water, which is one of the harder things to draw, we're looking at drawing every single frame. So we came up with a system that we call Spritical that allows us to use hand-drawn animations copied onto the location of a particle system. It just really gives us a way of multiplying this hand-drawn animation 1,000-fold.
Ooh, and I'm not going to push from the lady by the tush. That's bad. When a beauty's with a beast, it makes me awfully mad. Now I'll take my blade and ram it through your heart. Your eyes on me, boss, because I'm about to start.
Everything's a case of trial and error. For instance, we had shots of Donkey. It was actually someone's first day in production, and they made one change, which they thought was an innocent change. And the next day, we got back renders from about half a dozen shots with Donkey looking like a chia pet.
I think that the work on the Road to El Dorado is the embodiment of tridigital convergence. It uses the best of the visual qualities of traditional artwork with the next steps in the evolution of digital tools to achieve images we never had before.
Who's the guy?
You the guy,
no,
boy. You know you the guy.
Fine.